रेडी।
इन अ स्मॉल एफर्ट टुवर्ड्स स्वच्छ भारत द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रिवर्स वेंडिंग मशीन हैज अराइज। दिस रिवर्स वेंडिंग मशीन इज गोइंग टू हेल्प अस इन इफेक्टिव वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट। नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट व्हाट दिस रिवर्स वेंडिंग मशीन इज ऑल अबाउट। इट्स अ डिवाइस व्हिच इज गोइंग टू एक्सेप्ट द वेस्ट बेवरेज कंटेनर्स एंड द प्लास्टिक वाटर बॉटल्स एंड इट इज गोइंग टू इन रिटर्न गिव द यूजर the shopping coupons or free passes or maybe money as motivation. So the idea behind this reverse vending machine is to motivate people to throw the plastic bottles at the designated places only so as to reduce the pollution happening due to scattered plastic. Now this project work is basically presenting the conceptual design of a portable reverse vending machine which is going to help us in recycling the plastic waste. Moreover, as it is going to crush the plastic bottles, it is helping us to reduce the volume of the plastic and hence an effective waste management. Also, when the bottles are being crushed, it is making sure that these water bottles are not being used beyond the shelf life of the plastic. Hence, this project work is going to be helpful in many ways. Now, before I start explaining my project work, let me give you a brief idea about the data acquisition system. So basically, data acquisition system is simply the collection of data from various measurement points and then digitizing it for storage, analysis and presentation on a computer. The data acquisition system, they come in wide variety, providing so much of flexibility depending on the type of system we are going to use for creating our application. So basically, the variety which is available for data acquisition system are PCI series, PXI series, wireless, Ethernet data acquisition systems for test, measurement and automation applications. So typically, a data acquisition system consists of these five components. The first is transducers and sensors, which are generally required to capture the physical phenomena, maybe the temperature of a room or force applied on an object or pressure in a chamber, etc. Then the second component is the signal. Because the transducers have already converted the physical phenomena into the measurable signals, so these signals can be analog or digital in nature, but the important aspect with respect to the signals is that they should be of proper sampling rate, proper level, proper frequency, etc. And of course the shape also of the wave shape which is obtained. Then the signal conditioning part. Now at times what happens that the transducers, they capture the signals but the voltages are too high or too low or they are so noisy that it cannot be directly handled by the computer. So they need to be brought down to the level which the computer will accept so as to have the proper analysis of the signal taken up. Typically the signal conditioning will include the functions like amplification of a signal or attenuation of the signal, multiplexing, simultaneous sampling rates, etc. Then comes the DAC hardware. Now DAC hardware is acting as an interface between the computer and the outside world. Okay, so this DAC hardware, say for example, it has accepted the analog signal from the transducer. So the function of DAC hardware will be to convert this analog signal into a digital one so that the computer understands how it has to process and provide us the accurate information regarding it. The last component and an important aspect is the driver and the application software. If we talk about creating a customizable software, a customizable device which is for the instrumentation, acquiring and the control application, we need three things. The first one is a computer, the second one is an efficient software and the third one is a modular hardware. Now together these things are going to make up a virtual instrumentation, and for creating our application we have used LabVIEW because of the same. Now let's try to understand why we are using LabVIEW as a controller. What we have done in academics, we measure few parameters, feed it to a model, conduct the experiments and then we get some results. Now here we have a single line diagram for this. We feed the parameters to the model and we are getting the results. But the problem here is that we are unaware of the industrial constraints, the real time environment in which this particular device has to basically work. So we are simply working with some major set of parameters, feeding onto a model and trying to improve our model for conducting the experiments to get the desired results. If we want to really work with some flexible kind of environment where we are not just simulating the work, we are not just experimenting out of it, what we require is virtual instrumentation. Now, what virtual instrumentation is providing benefit to us? First of all, let's understand what the three components of virtual instrumentation are. That is data acquisition, analysis, and the presentation part. While we work with all the three components, we are not only experimenting our work, but we are trying to provide a real-time solution to the industry. Let's see how this is possible. In data acquisition, we are performing signal conditioning, A to D conversions. We are having the timing control and some digital protocols. Now, when the sensors are actually providing the signals, all these functions are happening simultaneously. Once the data acquisition part has been done, we move on to the second component of the virtual instrumentation, which is the analysis part. Now, here we are storing the data. If required, we are processing the signal online, which is an important aspect here, and then we are doing the analysis part. So hence we have a flexibility of processing our signals online as well as offline. Moving further to the third component of this virtual instrumentation, we communicate this analyzed set of data for presentation on a computer, where the communication is being done either wired or this can be wireless communication. So again, this is providing us the flexibility of transmitting the set of data from one component to the other. Now, we are covering the following in the presentation part. We do the data storage, we analyze, the data visualization is done, and of course the report generation is done, which is again a flexible part. Here we can represent the data in the form of some graph or a chart or an Excel sheet or a text file. So virtual instrumentation is providing a lot of flexibility in how we would like to acquire the data and finally do the presentation. Now let me show you the actual hardware which we have used for developing our prototype. In this case, we have used a double acting pneumatic cylinder, a solenoid valve to control the working of this cylinder, MyDAC, the data acquisition card, infrared sensor, and a relay, along with a 24 volt DC supply. Now let me explain you how all these components are going to work together to create a reverse vending machine. Basically, this infrared sensor is going to sense the presence of the bottle. Once it is sensed, it is going to send the signal to the data acquisition card. The data acquisition card will send the signal to the program which is developed on LabVIEW, and LabVIEW will generate another signal to this relay. Now this relay is going to switch on the supply from 24 volt DC supply to this solenoid valve. Once this solenoid valve is actuated, it is going to make this cylinder, the piston of the cylinder, expand and it will crush the bottle. And once the crushing of the bottle is done, the piston is going to move back. The solenoid valve will now sense that yes, the piston has moved back, and will send the signal back to the data acquisition card that yes, one bottle has been crushed. So this prototype has been developed using all the components. The following video will showcase how all these components are together working, and how the concept of reverse vending machine has been developed, though a lot of improvements are required for actual implementation of the device. Thank you. Thank you.